Welcome back inside Arizona Daily Mix. Right now we're going to talk about something that's a little tech savvy and a little scary at the same time. Joining us to break it down, we're talking with Don Alvarez. He is the partner of Radix Law. And I have to tell you, you're going to have to make this simple and make it sound good, because I'm not thinking I'm on board with this one, Don. We're talking about Amazon's new feature where they have a key that can actually deliver your packages into your home.
That's correct. And it's not only Amazon, but there are other companies such as Walmart and Target that are experimenting with this. Basically, it is a situation where the delivery person has an encrypted code mm-hmm. that can unlock your door. You have to buy special equipment for that, such as a camera, an electronic lock, and it also is compatible with your smartphone so that you can view it in real time or tape it and view it later. Delivery occurs.
So this is something that's provided through Amazon, so you're purchasing it from them?
Well, you can purchase the equipment mm-hmm. from Amazon, or you can get it from other people that sell it.
Okay.
It probably is a little cheaper getting it through Amazon.
Okay. So there's about 37 cities who are looking to do this, and this is because they're trying to stop the porch pirates, people who actually take, and we've seen the videos on the news of people taking packages off of people's porches or off of their front, you know, step right by their door and, you know, doing whatever they need to do with those packages. So is this going to eliminate that?
Well, it may help to eliminate that, but then it has other issues that people will come up with, such as giving a stranger access to your property.
Right.
And in the case of Walmart, the groceries that are delivered, if they're perishables, they have a system now where they have the delivery person go in and put those perishables in your refrigerator. So that's even more of an invasion of your privacy if you permit it.
Well, so, I want to know, what are the precautions that you need to take? Especially, is there a background check or something that they're doing specific to make sure that this employee abides by certain laws, rules, and standards to actually access someone's home?
Well, they say they vet these people, the delivery people. What does that mean?
Yeah, I don't know what
and
that means.
And how successful has vetting been recently in our history as it is? That means that the person didn't get caught, and so they come up clean. I don't know what that really means. But what's to stop that same person from casing your joint to give you to give someone access later, to tell another person, hey, you can go in there during these times because the homeowner isn't home, and burglarize?
Right. And do you think that this is the wave of the future in a good way, that we could see more of this, or is this something that they're just trying out because they want to have a solution to a problem that already exists with people taking your packages?
Part of that, I think it probably is the wave of the future.
No, Don, no. Let's go back. We were talking earlier. We want it to be old school.
Some of the things I understand they're looking at is leaving, giving the access codes to, for example, Mary Maids to come in and clean your house when you're not there.
Right.
Or probably a number of other types of uses. You have a camera there that you view it all, but what happens when a person goes snooping through your house, even though there's a camera there, or how much coverage does one camera give you?
Right.
How many cameras do you need? One of the things that I would do, and the best piece of advice I can give people, is to check with their homeowner's insurance to see what might be covered, because you never know. If somebody opens your door and you have a dog, what happens if the dog attacks?
Right.
What happens if the dog gets out and attacks? What happens if your beautiful little dog runs out, like my little dog would do if the door is opened? Well, regardless of who opens it, the dog is out. What happens if a person comes in, such as in the Walmart case where they come into your house, they slip and fall and hurt themselves because of some condition in your house that they were unaware of?
So there's all these different, you know, things that you must take in consideration. Convenience is great, but also you need to be aware that there's a lot that comes with that convenience.
Yes, of course, and that's why I say check with your homeowner's insurance, because a lot of times these contracts that you might sign with Walmart or with Amazon, they may have liability limitation clauses or waivers that, in which you say, okay, I'm accepting all the responsibility of anything that goes wrong, and you're holding harmless Amazon or Walmart or Target from anything that the delivery drivers might do.
Interesting stuff there. Again, his name is Don Alvarez with Radix Law. If you want more information, radixlaw.com. We'll also have a link on our website, aztv.com. This is scary, Amazon having a key to drop your packages off inside your home. Do you like it? Not like it. question a thought there. More of Arizona Daily Mix when we get back. It's crazy.